Hello friends, welcome back to HSA English classes. Today we are going to learn the essay The Trumpet Club by Richard Steele. Previous year question from the Trumpet Club: Who has the liberty of stirring the fire at the club? Answer is Sir Geoffrey Nosh. Now let us learn the summary of the essay. Trumpet Club indicate the growing popularity of club life in the early years of the 18th century. The essay begins with an epigraph by Cicero. The word trumpet is probably used in connection with the idiom to blow one's trumpet, meaning to boast. And each member of the trumpet club does just that. The satirical essay speaks of how the narrator chose to relax before retiring for the night. After a hard day's work, the narrator made it his custom to spend the evenings in the company of men where he did not have to exercise his mind much. Their talk lulled him to sleep. Richard Steele addresses his trumpet club members as shining companions. He spent 40 years in the trumpet club. Their conversation is a kind of preparative for sleep for Richard Steele. He was a member of this trumpet club, and their club consisted originally of 15 members. At present, it is said to consist of 5 persons. Sir Geoffrey Nosh, who is the oldest of the club, has been in possession of the right-hand chair, time out of mind, and is the only man among them that has the liberty of stirring the fire. This our foreman is a gentleman of an ancient family who lost all his wealth in gambling on hounds, horses and gaming cocks. He calls every thriving man a pitiful upstart. The story of the old gantlet is recounted by him. Another member is Major Matchlock. He is the next senior who served in the last civil wars and has all the battles by heart. He does not think any action in Europe worth talking of since the fight of Marston Moor. The Battle of Marston Moor was fought on 2nd July 1644. He used to give the description of the Battle of Naseby at 6:45. Honest old Dick Reptile is the third of their society. He is a good-natured, indolent man who speaks little himself but laughs at their jokes, and bring his young nephew along with him, a youth of 18 years old, to show him good company and give him a taste of the world. This young fellow sits generally silent. "A Jack, you young men think us fools, but we old men know you are." This remark is made by honest old Reptile whenever his nephew opens his mouth. The greatest wit of their company is Richard Steele. He was regarded as a man of letters. He was referred to scholar by Geoffrey Nosh and philosopher by Major Matchlock. Another member of the club is Benger of the neighboring inn. His only claim to fame was that he knew the notorious Jack Ogle well and would tell stories of his adventures and his visit to Caring Cross. He always used to quote the lines from the book Hudibras. The members met every evening at 6 p.m. and dispersed at 10 p.m. and the conversation was the same as it was for the past few years. On his way home, the narrator would reflect with himself the talkative nature of old men who would spin the same yarn. This made him also think that when a young man began to talk over a particular incident over a long period of time, the story would get elongated so long as to compete with the Canterbury Tales. Canterbury Tales is a number of long stories to have been told by a band of pilgrims on their way to Canterbury, a place sacred for the tomb of St. Thomas Becket. One way to avoid getting into this pitfall, according to the narrator, is to store up knowledge and observation in our youth and use and recall it in our declining years. This can make a man in his old age a man of wisdom comparable to that of Nestor. Nestor is a character in the Homer's Iliad known for his wisdom and eloquence. Thank you.